Hey, I'm Makosi Koza from East Coast Radio. We're here at the Oyster Box for the first of our cooking features. Today, though, we're not cooking. We're finding out what the fuss is all about oysters. Follow me.
Hello.
Hello.
No, hi there.
Yep.
We're nearly there. Good afternoon. I'm Kevin Joseph, Executive Chef of the Oyster Box Hotel. And welcome to the Oyster Box and the show with Makosi Koza. So the first dish is called Oyster Mary. And Oyster Mary is a take on a Bloody Mary, but with oysters in it. And for this dish, what we need is some lemons, the oysters, ice, fish ice, tomato juice, and oyster sauce, and that's why it's called Oyster Mary, and Smirnoff Red Vodka. Add some ice, two tots of vodka, a double, one tin of tomato cocktail, some juice of a freshly squeezed lemon, a little bit of black pepper, some salt, just a touch of oyster sauce, and I mean a touch. We're gonna take the meat out of one oyster, knock that in, then we're gonna shake this up. Shake. Piece of celery leaf. Again, just a squiz of Tabasco, and voila, it's done.
Those who know me know I don't drink, but for the sake of you up there, I'm going in. An acquired taste, but try it out. More oysters. No, it wasn't enough. Okay, we're back at the Oyster Box with Executive Chef Kevin Joseph, and like we did last time, more oysters. I can hardly wait.
Please. Okay, so this next dish is called Drunken Oysters, and one of the reasons why it's called that is the oyster actually gets drunk because we're using live oysters and we're using cane, obviously genuine Durban spirit. For this dish, I need you to assist me, just loosen the oysters, obviously get them into the shot glasses. But before we do that, I'm just going to put some cane into each glass, just a little bit.
Okay, obviously you're called the Oyster Box, but how much do you serve in terms of oysters?
Okay, well, the name arose actually, the Oyster Box, because of them selling the oysters, and that's why it's called. And we only utilize Natal oysters, and in average for a week, we sell anything between 4,000 and 7,000 oysters. It's a huge number. I challenge any other property to say that they do anything close to what we do.
The next one we open right.
Chopped up papaya, lemon wedges, red onion, green chili, finely chopped up coriander, some chilies for garnish, and some coriander for garnish and Tabasco sauce. All these items together. Now the chili, obviously not all of it. The onion, some of the coriander, some freshly squeezed lemon juice, salt, black pepper, and we're gonna mix all of that together. And we just slice the knife across, right? And see, it's loosened.
Okay.
There we go. Okay. And we're gonna top each one with a teaspoon of filling. And that's just to give it a bit of a fruity, tangy flavor to complement the cane. Okay. One of the second most popular oyster dish on our menu.
Ladies and gentlemen, the oyster is drunk. To paraphrase Rihanna, it's not the weekend, but cheers.
So this next dish, yep. One of the reasons why I'm showing you this is, you know, most people always eat oysters with either squeezed fresh lemon, Tabasco sauce, and just black pepper on top. Mm-hmm. And it's a bit boring, you know, every restaurant or hotel you go to, that's the standard way they serve it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna make up a dish with creme fraiche and fresh basil and chili, and you're gonna eat it with that. For this, I just need another mixing bowl, and we've got some creme fraiche and just some finely chopped tomato and about a tablespoon and a half of that, just slithers of basil, fresh and lime, and just squeeze some of the juice on them, some black pepper, some salt, and then obviously let's not forget the Tabasco. Good mix. Trick is not to put too much of lemon juice in this dish, because then it just makes the actual cream base a bit runny. And then we're gonna just spoon this onto that. Okay. And these can be made in advance and kept in the fridge. I wouldn't say more than an hour.
I don't even know how to eat it. I just literally just scoop it up. And
you just scoop it up with the cream and the oyster into your mouth. That's it. Much tastier than just eating a raw oyster.
Believe it or not, this is my first oyster ever.
And what did you think?
I'm glad my first time was with you, sir.
Excellent. Brilliant. Enjoy.